Hello everyone, this is second part of percentage. If you're watching this part directly, I would recommend you to first watch the first part because it is continuation and most of the things you will not get if you don't see the first part. So for watch the first part and then come to the second part. And in this particular video, in this particular part, we will solve few moderate questions. So let us start with the first question. The first question is, a number if reduced by 25% becomes 225. By what percentage should it be increased so that it becomes 375? Now there are two ways, there are actually many ways of solving this, but I will teach you two ways. First is the conventional way and the other way is using fractions. So let us start. Now it is said that a number if reduced by 25% becomes 225. Now let us take that number be x. Now according to the question, if a number is reduced by 25%, that means now the number is 75% of x and that is equals to 225. So that will be equals to 225. Now 75% is 75 into x upon 100 equals to 225. Now 25 threes are, 9s are, 1s are, 3s are. That means original number is 300. Now next it is said, by what percentage should it be increased so that it becomes 375? So the original number is 300, we have to increase it to 375, that means by what percentage? So that will be 375 minus 300 upon 300 into 100. So that will be 75 upon 300 into 100, 2 zeros gone, 1s are, 2s are, 25. That means the number 300 should be increased by 25% so that it becomes 375. Now other way of solving this question is, now see here it is said that a number is reduced by 25%. So 25% in terms of fraction will be 25 upon 100, that means 1 by 4. Okay. Now it is said that if a number is reduced by 25%, here it is reduced, so here I have to take minus sign, right? If it was increased, then I would have taken plus sign. So if a number is reduced by 25%, it becomes 225. That means it becomes, right? So this is original part after reduction, that is 4 minus 1, 3 units become 225. I repeat once again, a number if reduced by 25%, so 25% is nothing but 25 upon 100, that is 1 by 4. That is nothing but 1 by 4, okay? So it is 1 by 4. Now this 4 is original part and here it is said that it reduces. That means here it will be minus 1 and it is said that if a number is reduced by 25%, it becomes 225. That means after reduction, that is 4 minus 1, that is what, 3. So 3 becomes, 3 units is nothing but 225. Okay, so this 3 unit is nothing but 225, that means 1 unit is 75. Now next is, by what percentage, so the original number, now we have to find out the original number. The original number is 4, so and 1 unit is 75, so 75 into 4, that is 300. So original number is 300. Now they have told us by what percent should it be increased so that it becomes 375. So that means 375 minus 300 upon 300 into 100, that will give us 25%. So you will find that in this question, in this particular question, this way was little easier than this way. But if it was, if here the percentage was, for example, 57 1 by 7, then this would have been little difficult by solving this way. In this, when the fraction, when the percentage given is in the form of fractions or is very difficult or very huge number, so in that particular way, this way of solving, by solving the fractions way, is much more easier. So I want you to study both the ways and solve the question whichever way you find it easy. Okay, so now moving on to the next question. If 30% of A is added to 40% of B, the answer is 80% of B. What percentage of A is B? Now let us see. Let us see it step by step. Now it is said that if 30% of A, 30% of A, 30% of A 30% of A is added to, added that means plus, 40% of B, the answer is, that is equals to 80% of A. Now we will solve this. Now 30% of A will be 30 into A upon 100, and 40% of B will be 40 into B upon 100 is equals to 80% of B will be 80 into B upon 100, right? Now we will cancel this, we'll multiply throughout by 100, so this hundreds will be gone. Now 30A plus 40B is equals to 80B. So 30A plus 40B is equals to 80B. Now we will take this 40B on this side. So 30A is equals to 80B minus 40B will be 40B. So A by B will be, this zero gone, will be equals to 4 by 3. Now question is, what percentage of A is B? What percentage of A is B? So A is total, what percentage means what part of A? So total part will be 4, and here it will, what is B? So B is 3, so into upon 3 into 100. Here the question is, what percentage of A? That means the whole part is A. So in denominator we will take A, and that is 4, is B. So B is 3, so 3 upon 4 into 100, 4 ones are 25 za, so 25 into 3 is 75%. So the answer is option number D, 75%. Next question is, if 16 is added to a number, then result becomes 1162 by 3% of itself. Find the number. Now say, in this particular question, I will show you two ways of solving this. Whichever way you find it easy, you solve in that way. So let's start. Now first it is said that if 16 is added to a number, let us say that that number is x, and what we are adding, 16. So the number becomes 1162 by 3% of itself, that means of x. Okay, so we will solve this part now. 116 into 3 will be, 116 into 3, 6 3s are 18, 3 1s are 34, 348 plus 2 will be 350. So 350 upon 3 into 100, because we are converting this percentage into fraction. So into, and of will be into x. Now that means these two, this zero gone, and 5 7s are 35 and 5 6 are. So x plus 16 is equals to 7 by 6x. That means x by 6 is equals to 16. I am taking this x on the right hand side. That means x is equals to 16 6 are 96. So the answer is option number A. Now other way of solving this is, 1162 by 3%, we will convert this into fraction. Now what is this fraction? 7 by 6. We can get the answer from here. So it is 7 by 6. Now what it is said that, if 16 is added to the number, the result becomes 1162 by 3 of itself. That means this is the original number. This is the original number, and this is the new number formed. That means on addition of what new number is formed? That means on addition of 1, 7 minus 6 is 1. On addition of 1, new number is formed, that is unit 7. So what is this 1 unit? What has been added so that it has become 7 unit? 16 is added, right? 16 is added. So 7 minus 6, that is 1 unit, is nothing but 16 units. Okay. Now what they have told us, find out the number. So find out the original number. The original number is 6, and our 6 units, right? And our 1 unit is equals to 16. So 6 units will be 16 into 6, that is 96. I'll repeat this once again. You have to find out this 1162 by 3 into percentage into fractions, and that fraction will be equals to 7 by 6. Now that they have told us that on addition of 16, the number becomes 1162 by 3 of itself. That means this is the new number, this is the original number. And how this new number is formed? By adding 1 unit. And that 1 unit, here what they are adding, 1 unit is nothing but 16. So 1 unit is 16, and they have told us to find out the original number. Original number is 6 units. So we'll multiply 6 with 16 and we'll get the answer 96. So in either of the ways you can solve the question, whichever way you find it easy, convenient, you can solve in that way. So the answer is option number A, 96. Now let's go to the second question. The price of an article was first increased by 10% and then again by 20%. If the last increased price was rupees 33, the original price was. We will again solve this question in two ways. First way is the price of an article is increased by 10%. That means the price of the article is now 1110 upon 100. Let that a price of the article be X. Okay. And now it is said that the price of the article increases by 10%. That means now the price of the article is 110 upon 100. We are adding 10 with it. Now next it is said that then again it is increased by 20%. So we will multiply it by 120 upon 100. How do we get that? Because it is increased by 20%. So 100 plus 20 will be 120 upon 100. Because we are converting this percentage into fractions. So 110 upon 100 into 120 upon 100 into X. Now, and it is said that if the last increased price, last increased price is this. So this is equals to 33. On solving this, this 0 gone, this 0 gone. So 11 ones are, 3s are, 1s are, 4s are, and 4 ones are, and 25s are. So cost price, the original price of the article is rupees 25. Now other way of solving this is again we will use fractions. Not 10% is 10% is nothing but 1 upon 10, right? And 20% is nothing but 1 upon 5. So original price will be 10 into 5. This is the original price. So original price will be 10 into 5. That is 50 units is the original price. 50 units is original price. Now next is we have been told the last increased price. Here the increased price will be 10 plus 1 since here the price is increasing. So we will take it as positives. So 10 plus 1 11 and 5 plus 1 that is 6. So 66 units. Now it is said that the last increased price is 33. That means 66 units is equals to 33. So 1 unit will be equals to half, right? One value of 1 unit will be half. So 50 unit will be 50 into half. That means 25 rupees. So you can solve in either of the ways. So the answer for this question is rupees 25. Next question is, a reduction of 10% in the price of an apple enable a man to buy 10 apples more for rupees 54. The reduced price of apples per dozen is. Now let us say in this case it is said that a reduction of 10% in the price of an apple enable a man to buy 10 more apples for rupees 54. Now let us say the price of an apple be X. So reduced price will be, here it is reduced by 10%. So reduced price will be 90 upon 100 X, that is 0.9 X. Okay. So the reduced price is 0.9x. Now they have told us that because of the reduction of the price, he was able to buy 10 more apples. Now if I tell you that I have 100 rupees and price of each banana is rupees 20. So how many bananas can I purchase? So simply you have to take total money upon the price of banana, that is 5. So similarly, in this case, if I tell you that how many apples can I purchase with rupees 54, you have to divide it by the price of an apple. So 54 upon X. Now it is said that due to the reduction of the price, he was able to buy 10 more apples, right? 10 more apples. So if he earlier purchased 9 apples, so if suppose this was 9, so now he can purchase plus 10 apples with the price, when the price of the apple is reduced to 0.9X. I'll explain this again. Now see, it is said that the price of an apple, when the reduction of 10% of the price enables a man to purchase 10 more apples with rupees 54. So earlier he could purchase 54 by X apple. Suppose that was 9. Okay. But now he is able to purchase 10 more apples. So plus 10 apples. But with when the price of the apple is reduced to 0.9X. So 54 upon 0.9X. Okay. So on solving this, 54 upon 0.9X minus 54X upon equals to 10. So we'll take 54 outside upon X outside. So 1 upon 0.9 minus 1 equals to 10. So 54 upon X into 1 minus 0.9 will be 0.1 upon 0.9. That is 1 by 9. So 1 za 6 za is equals to 10. So X is equals to 6 by 10. That is 0.6. So now the apple of the price. Now the apple, original apple, because we have taken X as original price of the apple. So now reduced price of the apple will be 0.9 into 0.6. Now here the answer is 0.54. So this 0.54 is nothing but the reduced price of an apple. But in the question, they have told us to find out the reduced price of apples per dozen. So in this case, we'll multiply it by 12. On multiplication, that is 0.54 into 12, we'll get the answer as 6.48. So reduced price of apples per dozen is 6.48. That is option number A. Next question is, in an examination, there were 1000 boys and 800 girls. If 60% of the boys and 50% of the girls passed, find the percentage of the failed candidates. Okay. Now see, it is said that there were 1000 boys. So boys is equals to 1000 and girls were 800. Okay. Now it is said that if 60% of the boys passed, so 60%, 1000 into 60 upon 100, that means 600 boys passed. Okay, 600 boys passed. So here I'll write boys, girls. So passed boys is 600. That means failed boys is 400, right? Because 1000 minus 600 will be 400. Now next it is said that and 50% of the girls passed. So 800 into 50 upon 100 will be equals to 400. That means 400 girls pass. So 800 minus 400, that means 400 girls failed. Now they have told us to find out the percentage of the failed candidates. Now failed candidates is 400 plus 400, that is 800 upon total number of students is 1000 plus 800, 1800, okay, into 100. Failed students upon total number of students into hundreds. Two zeros gone. So fours are, nines are, so 400 by 9 will be 9, 4s are 36, 40, 40 will be again 9, 4s are 36, and again 9, 4s are 36. So the answer is 44.4%. That is option number C is the correct answer. Next question is, out of 2500 people, only 60% have saving habit. If 30% save with bank, 32% with post office, and rest with shares, the number of shareholders are. Now, in this question, it is said that 2500 people, out of 2500 people, only 60% have saving habit. So, let us find out that how many people have saving habit. So, that will be 2500 into 60 upon 100. So, 25 into 60 will be 1500. Okay, so the answer is, so the people is, so the 1500 people have saving habit. Now, it is said that if 30% save with bank and 32% with post office, that means 30 plus 32 people, that is 62 people save with bank and post office and remaining with shares. So 100 minus 62 will be 38%. So 38% people save with shares and we have to find out the number of shareholders. So the question is, out of 2500 people, 60% have saving habit. That means 1500 have saving habit. Out of which 62% people save with bank and post office and remaining 38% people save with shares. And we have to find out that shareholders, number of shareholders. So 1500 into 38 upon 100. So 38 into 15 will be 5 8s of 40, 5 3s of 15, 15 plus 4 will be 19, 8 3, 8 plus 9 will be 7. So the answer is 570. So the answer for this is option number B, 570. Next question is, 8% of the voters in an election did not cast their vote. In this election, there were only two candidates. The winner obtaining 48% of the votes defeated his opponent. Here it will be opponent. By 1100 votes, the total number of voters in the election was. Now let us say that there were 100x voters, okay? Let us say that there were 100x voters and it is said that 8% of the voters did not cast their vote. So out of 800x, 8% did not cast their vote. That means 92x people voted. We have taken 100x as the total number of voters, right? Out of which 8% did not cast their vote. So remaining will be 100 minus 8x, that is 92x voters cast their votes. Now next it is said, the winner obtaining 48% of the total votes. So out of 800x, winner is getting 48x, okay? From 100x, winner is getting 48x and is defeating his opponent by 1100 votes. Now read this sentence carefully. He defeat his opponent by 1100 votes. That means he is getting 1100 votes more than his opponent. Okay. So now in this case, the winner is getting 48x votes and the total number of vote casted is 92x. So loser candidate will be getting 92x minus 48x. Why am I doing this 92x minus 48x? Because winner is getting 48x and the total votes casted is 92x. And in order to find out the votes got by losing candidate, I have to subtract 48x minus 92x. Okay. So 92x minus 48x will be 44x. So the losing candidate, the loser, is getting 48x votes. Now it is said that the winner, after obtaining 48% of the votes, defeated his opponent by 1100 votes. That means he is getting 1100 votes more than his opponent. So that is 44x. So that is 48 minus 44x will be 4x. I am taking this 44x on the right hand side, on the left hand side. So 48 minus 44x will be 4x upon 1100. So x is equals to 1100 upon 4. Now the question asked is the total number of voters in the elections. The total number of voters we have taken as 100x. X is 1100 by 4. So total number of voters will be 1100 by 4 into 100. So 1s are 25s are. 25 into 1100 will be 27,500. So the total number of voters in the election was 27,500. So option number D is the correct answer. Next question is, a man spends 40% of his monthly salary on food and 1/3 of the remaining on transport. If he saves rupees 4,500 per month, which is equal to half the balance after spending on food and transport, his monthly salary is. Now let us say that his monthly salary be X. Now according to the question, he spends 40% of his monthly salary on food. So on food he spends 40x upon 100, that is equals to 2/5. So on food he spends 2x by 5. Now next is 1/3 of the remaining on transport. Now see, it is very important to read the question slowly and correctly, because if we miss this word remaining in this question, then we will take 1/3 of x and then we'll get the wrong answer. So for any competitive exam, it is very much necessary to read the question correctly, because even if you skip a single word, then there is a possibility that you may get a wrong answer. So in this question it is said that 1/3 of the remaining on transport. So 1/3 of the remaining, now 40% he spends on food, so remaining will be 60x upon 100, right? 60x upon 100, 60% after converting into fraction, it will be 60x upon 100. And out of this remaining, he spends only 1/3 on transport. So this two zeros gone, 1s are, 2s are, 1s are, 5s are. So on transport, he spends x by 5 rupees, okay? On transport, he spends x by 5 rupees. Now next he said that if he saves rupees 4,500 per month, which is equal to half the balance after spending on food and transport, his monthly salary is. So he saves 4,500, which is equal to half the balance left after spending. So balance left will be, total balance is X, total income is X, and he spends 2X by 5 on food and X by 5 on transport. Okay, because here it is said half the balance after spending on food and transport. So total balance is X and on spending on food and transport is 2x by 5 and x by 5 respectively. So 4,500 equals to half X. 2x plus X upon 5 will be 3x by 5. So 4,500 equals to half 5x minus 3x will be 2x by 5. So 1, 2, 2 gone. So x will be equals to 4,500 into 5. So that will be equals to 225,000. So the monthly income is 22,500. So option number B is the correct answer. So this is the end of the part 2. I hope you have understood all the questions. Thank you.